Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be showing you all of my beauty trash. And it seems like I just did one. I think it's because I did it late, wasn't it? Anyway, gosh, today is October 1st. Today is the 1 year anniversary of my son and his wife. So congratulations to them. And they are expecting their first baby, which he or she is due October 31st. We do not know what we are having until the baby arrives. They have opted to go old school and not find out. So anyway, very excited, cannot wait. I think it's going to be a boy. Of course, he wants a boy and she wants a girl. So we'll see. Anyway, so here pretty soon that baby's going to be here. We refer to the baby as Baby Rankin. So anyway, small update on my father-in-law. If you would have seen my Sephora haul, which was the last video that I posted, you would have known about all the issues I was having, which was a lot. But anyway, father-in-law ended up being in the hospital for a week. At first, they were going to send him to a facility after the hospital. Probably they were thinking a nursing home for rehab. He was in a car wreck and basically broke his hip. And he was doing so good with his physical therapy in the hospital that he's 72, Medicaid decided that he was doing too well, that they weren't going to pay for any type of therapy along those natures, so they sent him home. He does live alone. He lives in a small travel trailer, so he went to his other son's house, and he's been there ever since. They've been coming in every other day for physical therapy, and then has home health coming in. But he is doing very, very well. I just took him a couple days ago for a follow-up appointment with the surgeon. They did x-rays. Everything's healing really well. And he was going to get to graduate from a walker to a cane, using a cane this week. And they're thinking by the end of this month that he will get to be able to move back to his camper and be able to maneuver and be able to be by himself. So anyway, so that's good news. He did a lot better than what everyone was expecting, which I kind of figured he was, because he's just a little tough old little bird. So he's just a little bitty guy. Cracks me up, he's so little. But anyway, so everything's good. So some more housekeeping. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Janie. I like to post videos on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays, most generally. I do beauty, lifestyle, reviews, hauls, and a little bit of luxury thrown in here and there. And if you would be so inclined, push that little subscribe button and also push the little bell notification so that you are notified of all future videos. So let's get started with the empties. And of course, first thing I want to show you is my makeup wipes from Apple. Buy these at Big Lots, buy them in bulk when I go. Favorite makeup remover wipes, hands down. I have a body soak from Dr. Teal's. This is the Pure Epsom Salt Soaking Solution Coconut Oil to Nourish and Protect Skin. One of my favorites. I just really like this Dr. Teal's line of Epsom salts. The only thing is, I wish they sold these in bigger bags. And I found out why I'm going through them so quick, because I will rent a bath for my husband and I'll put some in for him. And I found out what he's doing when he goes in. He doesn't realize I put some in, and he puts in more, because I caught him the other day. I'm like, I already put the amount that you're supposed to have in there. So we're putting double the amount. So maybe my next bags will last a little longer. Another bath item I have is from Jason. This is a relaxing chamomile body wash. I heard, I think her name is Luxury Mom or something like that, talk about this line. And so I ordered some off of Vitacost, but I have also found some at TJ Maxx, and I absolutely love this body wash. It doesn't irritate me in no way, shape, or form, my arms, nothing. And I ordered the rose and I ordered the chamomile, and I used up the chamomile first because I really thought I would like the rose the best. Everyone knows I like rose, but gosh, this chamomile smelled really, really good. But it doesn't have any parabens, no harsh sulfates, no petroleum, no phthalates, and I just really, really liked it. So definitely, I don't need to repurchase because I had ordered quite a few, and then I found a bunch at TJ Maxx. So I am probably set on body wash for probably the rest of 2017 and 2018. So anyway, finished up a Becca backlit primer. I'm not going to talk a whole lot about this because this will be featured in my Project Pan update video, but I did finish that. I finished up a Brow Zing, or is that what that's called? Anyway, yeah, Brow Zing brow powder from Benefit. Finished up that powder. This is the wax. It's completely dried up. It's non-usable. So a MAC Prep and Prime in the color Rose, I think. This was one of those little contraptions where it is a little brush and you click this up and put it underneath your eyes for brightening. It was okay. Not going to repurchase. Okay. My battery light is flashing, so let me take a little break, change my battery, and I'll be right back. Okay, the next product that I have is from Sunday Riley, and this is the Tidal Brightening Enzyme Water Cream. This was a moisturizer that I used at night. It was okay. I don't think I'm going to repurchase it. Now, I will tell you, though, I mean, it was a pricey product. But this really lasted me a really long time because it didn't take very much at all. And it's kind of a green color. There's just a little dab left right there. But I'm using one right now that's kind of along the same lines from Kate Somerville. So that's why I'm not going to repurchase that. But who knows, I might decide later on after I use the Kate Somerville that I might be missing that and purchase it again. But anyway. I did finish a bronzer from MAC. This was from a summer collection a while back. This was called Aphrodite Shell, and it was just a little bronzer. This was in my Project Pan, so when you watch that video, you're going to see that. Finished up a eyebrow pomade from It Cosmetics, and finished that all up. What's left around the edges is all dried up. Cannot revive it. So that's gone. You didn't see that. Oh, this little guy. This is not empty. Let me get you up where you can see it so that you don't buy this. This was sent to me through Octoly, and this is the Jergens Natural Glow, Wet Skin Moisturizer. You're supposed to put it on after you get out of the shower or while you're still in the shower, and then it's supposed to give you a natural gradual tan. The problem with this was that you could not tell, or at least I couldn't tell, where I had rubbed it in at, where I hadn't rubbed it in at, where it wasn't rubbed in good at. And so I ended up with orangey, streaky legs and feet and ankles and knees and elbows and hands, and I didn't like this, so I didn't even finish it. It's going in the trash, so I don't recommend this. Anyway, for that reason, because it turned me orange. Excuse me, I gotta get a drink. Okay, this guy is not empty, but it's the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in Soft Brown. It's just so dried up that I can't work with it. Plus, to be honest with you, it's really too dark for me. So I'm not even going to, I tried using it for a while. I probably used it for a good month, 2 months maybe, trying to get it to work, but I just can't do it. It's just too dark and I'm not going to worry with it. I've had it for a long time too, so anyway. Some hair vitamins. This is the Sugar Bear hair vitamins, the little gummies. I think these are working pretty good. I know that I have some hair growth like right in here. I don't know if you can see that right there. My daughter likes them. She thinks she's getting some good hair growth from them. So, and they taste good. So I take two of the morning, and if nothing else, they just taste good. They're a little bit pricey, but what I do is I buy a 6 month supply. So it's cheaper that way, and then I give 3 bottles to my daughter and 3 bottles to me. So we split them. I'm gonna have to order us some more. So yeah, I will reorder them because I think they're good. I have about half a bottle left. Anyway, finished up a Ole Henriks Power Bright. This is a three-step. You get a polish, a brighten, and a glow. This was just a little sample pack that I got from Sephora. So I do like those. I used that while I was on my trip to Vegas. I just forgot to show it in the last haul. I have an eyeshadow that I finished from Milani. So I use this as an all over lid shade to create a canvas for my other eyeshadows to go on. What else do I have? I have a MAC strobe cream. This is just a little deluxe eye sample. I didn't really care for this. It's not anything that I think I would go and purchase the full size. It, like I said, it was okay. I have finished up a face wash. This came in one of my Mimi boxes a long time ago. I don't get those anymore because I got so overwhelmed with all the products that I was getting. But if you're interested in getting Korean skincare, go onto the Mimi Box website and see if they have any Mimi boxes. And because you get like a big sampling of different products. But anyway, this is the Pore Control Foam Deep Cleanser from Pro-U Cosmetics, I think is what that says. But it was a nice face wash. It wasn't irritating. It wasn't drying. I liked the pump system on it. It was really nice. My husband liked it. I don't know if it was so much pore control, but it did help, you know, to get everything cleaned out. So it'd be something that if I didn't have, you know, at least another 100 bottles of face wash, I would think about ordering one of those. But Lord knows, I don't need any more face wash. Some toothpaste, Crest White Brilliance. I try to use a whitening toothpaste all the time because I drink a lot of pop. Well, that white messed me up. There we go. So I drink a lot of pop, so I try to do what I can to keep them as clean as possible. But they're not ever going to get white. And as a kid growing up, we drank a ton of tea, iced tea. So I have some stained teeth. But anyway, this is good stuff. This is probably one of my favorite items from The Ordinary. And this was the lactic acid. I did finish that. That was used up this morning. And I am definitely going to order another one of these at some point in time here pretty soon. I have some glycolic acids that I'm going to use up first. Then I'm going to order that. I have some lipsticks that are just old and they have gone off as far as smell, but it's from the Rimmel line. This is the Provocalypse, and if you want a really good drugstore liquid lipstick, I recommend these. I think they're really good. Plus they have a really cute cap on them. Can't go wrong. They're inexpensive. They're from the drugstore, and that way when they go off, you don't feel so bad about having to throw them out. But I've had them for quite some time, so it's time for them to go. I have another product that was in my project pan. This is the little peach eye brightener from Giorgio Armani. I don't remember what it's called, but I did finish that up. And I have a couple more that are kind of similar to this that I want to use up, and then I'm going to order another one of those probably during the VIB sale, possibly. I have a Shiseido Bioperformance Super Exfoliating Disc that I finished or used. This is just the packet. It's just a little round disc that has like a cleaning agent in it for your skin. And the disc itself is kind of like a silk filling, so it's very smooth and very exfoliating and smell. Oh my gosh, those things smell so good. And I'm pretty sure you can still purchase these. I found mine at Marshall's on clearance a while back, and they came in a box of I think 7 or 8, and I bought all the boxes they had because they were like really, really cheap. So I probably have like another dozen of these to use, but I really do like those. Those are really good for a face wash. Okay, I have some samples that we want to talk about. One is called Hydra Life from Dior. It was a moisturizer. It was okay. I don't think that it was spectacular enough to spend the money on it, because you know if it's from Dior, it's a little bit overpriced. Then I have the La Mer, the Transformation Lotion. Again, it was okay. Did not wow me enough to want to go out and spend the money on this product. Then I have from the manufacturer a Soothing Active Fresh Peel. This was the Apple Puri Peeling Gel. This was in a sample of products that I ordered, and there was all the instructions are in Korean, so I didn't really know how to use this. So I think I would have liked it better if I would have known how I was supposed to use it, but anyway, so there was that. But this guy I was able to figure out. This is the manufacturer Aqua Moisture Sleeping Cream Pack, and this was a deep moisture surge. It was a sleeping pack, and I got about a week's worth of product out of this, and this was really, really nice. I really did like this. So this was a hit with me, and this was again a sample that was sent to me with a order. So anyway, that was good. Okay, so we've got time to talk about I'm gonna do those products. Okay, I have some Monet products, okay, but I want to do these in a separate video because I want to have time to bitch about some products that people are using and selling that don't work. Anyway, thank you so much for watching me today. I hope you have enjoyed. Give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that little bell icon for future videos. I would appreciate it, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.